偷偷爱上你以后，变成爱情的凶手，只跟踪你的脚印，即使动态 follow。Hello， 大家好，我是 Cindy 袁咏琳 ，You're watching Razor TV。
From her album cover to her Moulin Rouge-esque music video。
Only 不问对不对，听从我任性指挥。你说我的爱很珍贵。
And her recent appearance at Loud Festival.
Big up!
Jay Chou's protege singer-songwriter Cindy Yan shows that she's not shy about flaunting her shapely legs, which you can't tear your eyes away from. But the Taiwanese-American singer is more than just looks and legs. She packs a punch with her songs as well. For one, the 25-year-old is an accomplished composer and musician. She penned the melodies to all of the songs in the two albums she released so far. The self-titled first album and her second and latest, To Be Different. Perhaps she has her classical training on the piano to thank, which she started when she was 4 years old. Doesn't she remind you of Jay? In town for album promotions, Cindy herself admits she feels an affinity to Jay.
Not just that we play piano, we compose and we produce, but that our parents both are divorced, and he also went through a lot of similar things that I went through in school.
Since she broke out into showbiz with the album Cindy in 2009, she has been making music her own. So she's quick to dismiss the idea that her record label is trying to promote her as the female equivalent of Jay.
Definitely not female Jay, just that I can be as successful as Jay. When I first got to JVR, the first person I actually interviewed with JR, who is the boss, the big boss, both our managers, and he was the one that signed me. He would always, you know, mention that I should, you know, just again, 结论学习. And I think it's very good advice. He's always saying, you know, tell me stories about Jay to give me confidence and to encourage me. It was his way to encourage me. And, you know, he also said that he hasn't signed anybody since Jay these past 10 years, really. I'm the first one. And to him, that's a big step. That's a big investment. And so I think inside, he probably hopes that, of course, I can be successful like Jay.
In fact, would she say she's better than Jay? We asked her to name one thing she does better than her boss.
Oh, violin. Because he doesn't play violin.
He doesn't play violin?
He doesn't.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's the one thing that he can't play that I can play. But I can't play cello, but he can play cello.
Oh.
So I think 我们的强项在不同的地方.
Cindy first made headlines 2 years ago with this duet with Jay. A dream for any fan of Jay for sure. But having grown up in Texas, the petite songstress admits she wasn't really a fan at first.
I knew who he was. I heard some of his songs, but in all honesty, I didn't really know that there was JVR music. I didn't know that he had his own company. I didn't know how big he was. That was all very new to me. And then I went online, I Googled him, and I Wikipedia'd him, and I found out more about who he was. I was like, okay, well, this is my boss, so I got to find out who he is.
So how was the interaction with him, like,
the first time?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't remember. The first time, it was in China. I went to his concert, and it was on my birthday, 2 years ago. Oh, no, 3 years ago. And I was so nervous. It was my first time meeting a celebrity. And so you can imagine, we were very starstruck. And I mean, he was very just normal, you know? He was just like, hey, I think he was more shy than I was. Yeah, because I'm ABC, and to him, that's like a 距离. And so he didn't know what to say to me. He said hello, I said 你好. And that was about the extent of our conversation. You know, over the years now that, you know, we see each other more often, you know, and now it's like he's my big brother.
And despite the success of the song, she did not collaborate with Jay this time.
Because Hua Sa was such a success to me, I feel like that I would be scared if I made another song and it wasn't as successful. Mm-hmm. That's like a yali, you know? Mm-hmm. And also, this album is completely me. Mm-hmm. And I want the focus to be just who I am and what I want to give my audience. Mm-hmm. And that's why, and also he's too busy to even have time right now. And I understand that.
Next, Cindy tells us if sparks will ever fly between Jay and her.